Hello everyone, it is part 2 to make a calculator using a console application. Now we are going to define put res equals to res equals to should be here in my phone. Here, res equals to a double dot parse text box dot text. And then we are going to add the buttons. We are going to use for loop int I equals 0, I less than 6, plus plus I. We have 5 rows, and we are going to use for int j equals 0, j less than 5. We have 5 columns plus plus j. We are going to use if j greater than 0 and j less than 4, and I bigger than 1 and I less than 5, or I equals to 5 and j equals to 2. And or I equals to 5 and j equals to 1, fill number of I and j, and it is a method. We are going to define it later. Else if j equals 4 and I bigger than 0 and I less than 6, or I equals 0 and j equals 1, or it's not or. We are going to use the fill operations operator I and j, else if I equals 5 and j equals 3, you are going to use fill equal I and j, else if I equals 0 and j bigger than 1 and j less than 5, or j equals 0 equals 0 and I bigger than 2 and I less than 6, fill up I and j, and then else if I equals 2 and j equals 0, then fill pi, else fill standard up. After that we are using invalidate to show everything, and I am going to define that method. Int I and int j and it must be public void, and we are going to use button equals new button and then button dot height equals 35, button dot width equals to 50, and button dot left equals to 5 plus button dot width plus 5. Multiple by j, and button dot top equals to 105 plus button dot height plus 5 multiple by j multiplied by I. and the button dot text equals to s of number of n, and button dot click equals to plus equals to new dot new event handler button click. Button clicked. And then we are going to use this dot control add button and plus n. Now we are filling the operators, public void fill operator int I int j and we are going to use the button upo p equals to new button and I am going to fill everything as like as this one. I am going to pause it and coming back when I have filled already all those things for each button. As you see, I have defined the button clicked and we are going to use them and we are going to, this is class my, okay, we are going to use void button clicked object sender with big O event args E, maybe it must be O. And we are going to check if text box dot text equals to 0 or enter value then we make it text box dot text equals empty and enter value equals to false and we are going to use button num equals to button sender, this is this sender and it must be a big object and then we are going to use if num.text equals to comma, that is comma, if text box dot text dot contains already comma, if it contains, then text box dot text equals to text box dot text plus num dot text. Else if not contains, if not contains we do so, otherwise we are going to use this method again here, this expression here. Now we are going to must be here after this, not that. Now we are going to define another button click void button equal click. Object sender event args e, let me make it object so that I can share, and we are going to switch operation case plus text box dot text equals to res plus double dot parse double parse text box dot text dot to string, and then break, and then case minus copy, it is minus here, and we are going to copy, paste, and it is multiple, and here is multiple, and if it is this one, it's going to be this one too, and we are going to use again if it is x powered by y, is reminder. Here we must check something. You are going to use if double dot parse of text box dot text. Equals to 0, then we are going to show a error message dot show cannot divide by 0. Enter non-zero digit. Else is this one. Okay, it is a button open. Button equal clicked, it was switch, and this one is there. Now we are going to use void button pi clicked of this one, and we are going to use text box dot text equals to 3.14592 6535 8996 7633.2 string, and another is void button upo upe click equals to button sender and then up equals to num dot text and then switch case C. We have text box dot clear and then text box dot text equals to 0 and then break, and the rest of them I am going to put is going to take long time. I am back again, and I have defined a string variable mp, which is the memory memory plus, and you are going to put the text box text box inside that variable, and we are going to make the text box 0. If it is m minus, the memory is going to be empty, and even text box, and if it is memory, the text box is going to show what is in memory. And for plus minus, if you have a positive value, it's going to be negative. If it is negative, it's going to be positive. And the default is when you want delete digits on digits, and it is if the text box lane is positive, you are going to decrement the length with 1, and if text box is empty, we are going to put 0 in text box. Okay, now we are going to see the another standard operation, and I am going to put and show you how it is. I'll put the pause. Now I am back, and the standard operations, we are going to make a button, and we are going to put the text of the button inside the operation, and we are going to put in the result what is stands in the text box and make it text box empty, and we are going to switch the standard operation, and the case is x up to powered by 2. We are going to use that expression if it is a squared, and the digit is less than 0 or equal 0, it is going to be error message, and otherwise we are going to use the squared, mathematical squared. If it is 10 powered by x, it is also mathematical power expression, and in log, if the rest is negative or 0, we are going to get a error message. Otherwise, we are going to use the mathematical logarithm. And if e powered by x, we are going to use the mathematical exponential. Now everything is okay. Now we are going to run. And it's running here. I'm waiting. Line 14. We have got error message. What is line 14? Line 14. Line 77, 55. It is this one, and Okay, I am going to check what is the mistake. Okay, it was a very little mistake, and we are going to run. Now, as you see, all the buttons, it is 6 row and 5 columns, and we have replaced them with those conditions. Oh, sorry, we have replaced them with all those conditions. The numbers and the numbers, all of them, and the operators, all of them, the equal there, up is those things together with mood, and then pi here, and then standard operations like these and these. Operators was those things. Okay, now we are going to 12 plus 4 is 16, and minus 2 is 14, multiplied by 5 is 70, divided by 7 is 10, and we are going to use clean, and we are going to show pi, and we are going to reduce each number, and we are going to use 7 and minus, and we are going to use 10 up to minus 7 is that one, and we are going to use a squared on this. We are going to use log. We are going to use expression. We are going to use that one, 2 up to power by 2 is 4, and 4 power by 3 is 64, and we are going to put 64 in memory, and 8 divided by memory is that one, and we are going to use memory empty, and we are going to show that it is empty, and 5 mod 2 is 1, and everything is working. See you. Thank you for watching. See you in the next tutorial.